Good evening, this is Ergonomics. Tonight's video will go over my two Kodak Vigilant cameras. To the left is my Kodak Vigilant with the f4.5 anastigmat lens. And to the right is my Kodak Vigilant with the Kodak Kodar 8.8 lens. This video will go over the similarities and differences of both cameras. To start, both cameras are folding cameras, and both of them have an advance knob, shutter release, and a top release plate button, which will release the bellows inside of each camera. I'm going to pause the video for a second to open each one so you may get a better look at the cameras in their open state. So now we have both cameras in their open states, and as you can see, they are both similar and yet different. The similarities, both of them fold. Both of them have little feet that they can stand on for portrait shots, and both of them are capable of focusing by turning the front element glass. However, both of them do share differences at the front. This one goes from f4.5 to f32. And this one, being the Kodar, goes from f8.8 to f32. So the anastigmat has a more diverse aperture selection. In addition, it also has more choices for your shutter speeds, ranging from time and bulb, which the Kodar does have time and bulb, and from 1/10 of a second through 1/200th of a second. In contrast, the Kodar only goes between 25 and 1/100th of a second. So the anastigmat that you see on the left would be better suited for many of today's higher speed films because it has both a faster top shutter speed, and you could even shoot it in darker situations because of the faster aperture. Moving along, if I turn both cameras sideways, both of them have the same structure for holding up the bellows and the lens slash shutter combination. And if we go back to looking at the top of each camera, we can see both of them have viewfinders that you would be able to use to look through and take a picture. However, the 4.5 viewfinder is slightly different from the 8.8 viewfinder in that the 4.5 has a manual parallax correction switch. The 8.8 does not. That being said, the 8.8 can have the manual parallax finder installed after the fact, and they can be found on eBay and they can be easily installed with small tools. Both the Vigilant 8.8 and the Vigilant 4.5 use the same type of locking mechanism to hold the door in place, and both of them open in a similar fashion. Simply you'll pull the door, open the latch, pull the door, and both of them open to show, come on, there you go, that they are designed to take 6-20 film. both of them shoot 2.25 by 3.25 negatives, and both shoot 8 exposures per roll. If we look inside, we can see that the rear element for the 4.5 is substantially larger than the rear element for the 8.8. Again, this goes back to the camera's stance in the Vigilant hierarchy. The 4.5 is a more technically advanced camera than the 8.8. Moreover, you may have noticed on the 4.5 that it has a slight blue tinge to it. The 4.5's lens has what's called a luminized coating, which means all glass elements are fully coated for better color reproduction. There is no such confirmation of that on the Vigilant 8.8. That being said, considering what films were like in the 40s, I don't know how much luminizing would play a role in enhancing film contrast and color saturation, but I can attest to my Medalist 1, which is not luminized, it's only partially coated, versus my Medalist 2, which is fully coated, that the Medalist 2 does have slightly more punch, but it's not as significant as I feel Kodak would have made it seem in the mid-40s period. So I'm going to start wrapping up this video by saying both of these cameras are very capable in shooting 6-20 film, and both of them with re-rolled 120 are very much good users today. Things to look out for: I would be wary of the bellows, because the bellows do have a tendency to crack and leak. Kodak, for some reason, used paper-type bellows rather than leather bellows. I would also be aware of the fact that you do have to re-roll the film from a 120 spool to a 6-20 spool. And certain things such as the flash sync function, which both of these do have, may not be as easy to get to work as back in the 40s. That being said, either one of these cameras could be bought on eBay for about $25. In fact, I bought the 4.5 for $25, including shipping, and the only thing it needed was the slow speeds to be recalibrated. So they can be had for cheap, and if you're looking for a nice mid-range, medium format camera, and you want to be able to shoot 6x9, and you don't want to spend a lot of money, a Vigilant with a 4.5 is an excellent choice. And if you can find one with the anastigmat special lens, which is the 4.5 with higher quality glass, jump on it. They're very rare. I've only seen about 3 of them on eBay in the past 5 or 6 years. But the lenses are excellent, and the lens alone would make it worth getting the camera back up and running. On the other hand, I'm not going to discount the Vigilant with the 8.8, because it does have its charm. It's a very nice entry to mid-range camera that if you're looking to get into 6x9, you don't want to spend a lot of money, but you don't want to run the risk of having an almost sterile shot, then having a less powerful lens can give you a certain lo-fi charm, if you will. I find that the lo-fi charm, though, works best with a camera like a Brownie, but you can get some very nice shots from the 8.8. This is Ganzonomy. I thank you for watching my brief similarities and difference video between these two cameras. I hope you've enjoyed it. Please like and subscribe. If you find one of these two cameras on eBay, by all means grab one for yourself and have a go. Thank you. Subscribe, like, and comment. And if I missed anything in the video, I may put it in the summary section. I know that I missed the fact both of them are front focusing lenses and they don't unit focus, but this is just an introductory to the two as a comparison. Thank you and have a great night.